Because I have emetophobia, which is the fear of throwing up, I kind of developed a fear of food. And that's how my eating disorder happened. So I kind of, you know, I like to analyze. I'm an overthinker, so I like to analyze everything. And so that's what happened. That's how I had my eating disorder, is because of the fear of food, and which was caused by my fear of throwing up. And so the first time I just got my appetite back from drinking the holy water.
Okay.
But then when I relapsed, it was just, I think, how long did I have it? I had it for about, I think 2 years. I was just, I guess, gradually getting better on my own. Because the reason was, because of the fear of food, I kind of lost my appetite. And so I was, I guess, just waiting for my appetite to come back. So it's so strange to me now, because if I lose my appetite, it just stays for about a day or a few days. But then I can't imagine my life without food. So I guess it was a lot of things happening with, you know, with my mental health, anxiety, of course, my fear. So there were a lot of things that caused that. And then also my mom passing away, and I didn't have her support.
Okay.
And my dad was always working. So I was mostly on my own. And it was hard to overcome that. But then I remember in Germany, the way that I overcame it was just kind of gradually eating more and more. And I think it's easy to gain weight in Germany, because they like to eat sausages, they like to eat a lot of meat and bread. So I did gain weight afterwards, and I overcame that. But then a lot of things happened afterwards. You know, with this journey, I have so many realizations. And so after that, I actually, until now, I still suffer from body dysmorphia. So it is...
Which means...
It is, I'm skinny. I know that I'm, you know, I have a normal weight, but then you kind of don't see it yourself. So when people say, oh, you're so skinny, I love your body or something, when you look into the mirror, you see something else.
How do you call that body dysmorphia? Okay, so you don't see it. Okay.
Yeah, so after that, because I wanted to be a model, the dream came afterwards. From wanting to gain weight and wanting to be that normal weight, I decided that I wanted to be a model. And that's when I saw other people and I saw other models. And that's when you start comparing yourself to them, and you see what you don't have and you see what you would like to have. And so that's when it started. And actually, from wanting to gain weight because of my eating disorder, I started a diet. Mm. And the exact opposite happened. I wanted to lose weight.
Oh, okay. All right. But today, as we speak, you're okay.
I'm trying to be okay.
You're trying to be okay. That's
yeah,
okay.
But I'm much better now.
You're a lot better now. Okay.
I'm really embracing who I am, and I think a lot, having or practicing self-love, it is what really helps me in this journey of, you know, accepting my weight and accepting that I have gained weight, because There was a time where I kind of liked the way that I looked, and I liked the weight that I had. But then with being isolated and not being able to move during the pandemic, I did gain weight. And so I was struggling with accepting the way that I looked, because you know how it is in the Philippines. They like to judge you from the way that you look. They're going to say tumabaka, or, you know, all those comments. They like to say that the moment that they see you again. And so I was kind of afraid to go out afterwards. I didn't want to hear those comments. But then I realized that you cannot kind of, you can't control that. You can't control those comments, but what you can control is the way that you feel about those comments.
That's true. And because you have no control over what they say. But thank you for raising that. Dahil marami ang nanonood sa atin, wala kamang malis, wala mang intent na masama. You know, but we have to be very careful because we don't know the battle that a person is fighting. A simple comment like, ang taba mo, ang payat mo, can actually profoundly affect a person. Hindi man, kasi sometimes we would say, uy, wala akong ano, ha? Wala akong malisya, wala akong intent. But you have to be very careful. Like you, for example, you're very pretty. And then how would one know when you say, hey, Maureen, did you lose weight? Diba? It's sometimes with concern or, oh, you gained a lot of weight, etc. Now I'm learning. I should be more careful when I make comments because I don't know what, you know, the other person is going through. But Maureen, halimbawa, just to other girls watching this conversation, when a girl who is who's battling eating disorder, for example, disorders, paano ang response mo dapat nun? How do you actually tell the person that it is not right to comment or to ask me that question? Hard, no?
It's really hard, yeah, because sometimes, well, the thing is, if it's really, really bad, then it is your responsibility to tell her because you cannot help them unless they see it themselves. It's really that you can tell them, but if they don't see it themselves, if they don't see that they have an issue, if they don't see that they need help, nothing's going to change. So it's really to kind of raise awareness and to tell the person that they should maybe consider. Right. But you have to choose your words wisely because you can really hurt them with your words.
That's true. No, but you also have to surround yourself with people who you can really trust and who know you. Yeah. Like, in instances like this, paano kasi nusuportahan ni JK? I mean, who knows you very well? Kailangan mo yan eh, di ba? Yung kailangan mo lang yung support. You have to be surrounded by people, not really, by dad, by your siblings, or by JK, because it can be challenging. Really challenging. No?
Yeah, it can be really challenging, but it's really me kind of seeing that I have an issue. And I admitted to myself just 2 years ago. Actually, not admitted to myself, not only to myself, but to my sisters, that what was going on with me, the body dysmorphia. Okay. At the time, I didn't know there was a term for that. I thought it was another eating disorder because I was familiar with my past eating disorders. And so it's really about admitting to yourself that you need help.
And then you can talk about self-love.
For more videos and updates, just click here to subscribe. Laging kasama.